The molding technique is not only used for pralines but also for large molds to make so-called hollow figures. What's so typical about hollow figures? Here are a number of examples. It's important that hollow figures have a nice gloss, are hard and have a good crunch. The thickness of the edges of the figures, seen in cross-section, has to be even. Not too dense, but certainly not too thin. You can finish hollow figures in various ways, as you can see here. Very simply, pipe out lines in two directions, let harden briefly, and then pour in the chocolate. The second praline is simpler. We have poured chocolate of a certain color in a mold, added a second color, then a third, and then swirled it with a brush or a finger. After it hardens, pour in the chocolate. This is a simple model. We've used coloring that's soluble in fat. Sprinkle some in the mold. Here I've used three different colors. Then take a drop of chocolate and spread the coloring as you like. Let it sit for a while, then pour in white chocolate. This is a variant identical to the previous one, but here we used cocoa powder. And finally this mold. Just take a brush with dark or milk chocolate or both, simply brush once or twice, let sit, and then pour in white chocolate. As you can see, there are quite a lot of possibilities. Just unleash your creativity.